guys, what's up? Skib 137 coming at you with the 14th edition of the Goalkeeper News. I never thought I'd reach 14, really. I thought I'd run out of topics by now, but there's something I've been wanting to say for a while that I've never really mentioned. It's about managers. And obviously, managers are a vital role in football. They help the team with tactics and training and things like that. But what has started to grind my gears a bit is managers getting replaced so early and they don't have a chance to prove themselves. Obviously, there's two main examples of that, both from the exact same club. Andre Villas-Boas from Chelsea and Roberto Di Matteo. Andre Villas-Boas, young manager, you've got to give him time. He's not going to be perfect the first time round. Obviously, he did really well with Porto before Chelsea invited him in. And he was doing well to start with, and then he had a bad run of patches of games where I think it was like 5 losses or something, and in the Champions League, there was a few losses. But then, obviously, with him being sacked, Roberto Di Matteo came in as interim manager. And with him being interim manager, he went and won the FA Cup and, for the first time in Chelsea's history, the Champions League. Now, if that doesn't save you your job, I don't know how anyone at Chelsea is ever going to be a manager for a long time. Obviously, most of you will know what I'm on about and about how Roberto Di Matteo got sacked this year after winning the FA Cup and the Champions League, because he lost 5 games and had a poor Champions League run. Now, what in my head, I don't know what Abramovich is thinking, why, oh, he's lost 5 games and had a bad Champions League run, get rid of him. It's not like he hasn't gone and won you an FA Cup and a Champions League in one season. In my mind, that is really impressive. I was going to swear then, but I didn't. Why would you sack him? I would not sack him. Roberto Di Matteo's a good manager. What he did at West Brom was fantastic. He brought them back into the Premier League and stopped them being the yo-yo team that they were. That was until he left to join Chelsea as the assistant manager, and Roy Hodgson took over at West Brom. The other thing I'm thinking about is that in some teams there are managers who can lose and lose and lose and lose and lose and stay there. Like, obviously, QPR finally got their first win of this season after 17 games against Fulham, which is very, very, very poor. Obviously, they've drawn a couple of games, not many, but Tony Fernandez, I think, who's the chairman at QPR, kept Mark Hughes in for 15 games. He lost and drew most of them. Didn't win. Didn't get 3 points on the board from one game. 15 games, and then he gets sacked. How could someone do that? And then someone who wins an FA Cup and a Champions League get sacked after just a loss of seven games? I mean, it doesn't comprehend with me. Like, how could that possibly work? There's also, since I'm from South Yorkshire, Sheffield Wednesday, Dave Jones isn't having the best of seasons, not won many games, but yet Milan Mandarić is keeping him there. He could have just gone, get out, you're doing crap, get out. But he hasn't. He's sticking with him because he has the faith in him. That's what I want to see more of. Like, obviously, you can see from my bedroom, City fan. Everyone knows that. Sheikh Mansour, obviously, City have had the really, really bad Champions League season. I never thought we'd get out of the group stage. I would have been surprised if we even got the Europa League. In my honest opinion, that's not being a pessimist. That's just being realistic. But Sheikh Mansour, even though Mancini's had the bad Champions League season, he's doing well in the Premier League, he's keeping him in. Keep him. You need to keep someone in. You need to let them settle in the team. Like, Chelsea have got Rafa Benitez as an interim manager on until the end of the year. That's not going to help. He's going to be there for 6 months. He's not going to have enough time to get the players playing how he wants to and get them going in a way that they should work under one manager who's been there for a while. Obviously, look at Southampton. Southampton with Nigel Atkinson. He's been there since they're in League One. He's got them up to the Premiership. Admittedly, they're not doing well, but he's a manager who's been there for a while. His players know how to play under him. They don't need another manager. They don't need to kick Nigel Atkinson out. He's doing well. Yeah, admittedly, Southampton aren't mid-table, near the top, doing the relegation zone, but who cares? Brian McDermott, Reading, has been there for a long, long time. He's keeping his team playing how he wants to play, and that's proven well in the Premier League. Yes, Reading, Southampton don't have the best teams in the world. They've had to bring in new players just to try and survive, but they're doing well. If I'm honest, if I were in the Premier League, I'd be happy to win at least like 2 games a season, in my honest opinion. But I'm rambling on a bit, so I'm going to end the video here. Leave me a comment down below just saying what you think on managers nowadays. Should they be given a lot more time to try and work their like playing styles into teams, or should they be given the boot once they start losing? Anyway, it's been your boy Giver137, and it's been the 14th edition of the Goalkeeper News, and I hope you enjoyed it.